Before we begin LJPCBM episode number 860, I would say, first of all, the past two incidents I had back in the 858 and 859, I have to say, this might be the personal thing which I won't say on the web anymore, because I won't be able to talk about it that much anymore. This is a personal thing I say on the web, and for future references next time, I'm not going to say it. So, for those of you who want to not talk about it, feel free to talk to me, and we'll go from there. Hello guys, this is Jerry speaking. Welcome to Just React, episode number 860. And today I'll be at to the Fairy Odd Gamer, the Dora the Explorer games, and oh my god, this is going to be a big game. I'm like, Jesus, I am not happy, I'm not ready to watch Dora. And if you watch this remix, Dora the Enforcer, she has guns. If you, oh, got a message from somebody, at the, oh my god, let's see. Okay, it makes more sense, from Andrew, okay, never mind. Okay, I'm not gonna say it, but that's for me. Anyway. But anyway, let's react to this beginning in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Wow. Oh, God. Hold on. Give me a moment. Dora the Explorer games, and this is getting boring. Anyway. Togo designed by Boom Mario 1016. Okay, makes more sense. Continue on.
Hello, internet viewers. I'm the Fairly Odd Gamer. As you may recall, in the last two videos I made, I've done games that are either based on a new movie from a franchise already known, or based on a live action movie that was already famous at the time.
Okay.
That got me thinking, what is it about remakes that keep us coming back for more? Well, here's the thing. Remakes are everywhere nowadays, from movies, TV, and
of course, video games. Whoa. What is a fight, Boots? Tell me. What are you doing?
What was that? Anyway, in my opinion, I think remakes are...
Huh. Swipe
the box.
Wow.
What do I do? I don't know if he can play for me. I know what to do. I gotta practice. Lock it up. Never let him in.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
And why is the door locked?
Wow. It's Boots. Okay.
Thanks for opening the door.
Boots the monkey?
Yep, but you can call me Boots.
Fairly Odd Gamer. Nice to meet you.
Hey, gamer. Nice meeting you too.
Wow.
Wait a minute. Is this one by Nickelodeon?
You're getting warmer.
Oh my gosh. So you're telling me there's a live action remake of Dora?
Yes, that's exactly what I wanted to tell you about.
Okay. Well, in that case, Dora the Explorer.
Okay.
Yeah. Not many people know about this. Anyway, the shows that I remember watching on Nick Jr. were Blue's Clues, Little Girl, The Backyardigans, and the topic for this video, Dora the Explorer.
Yes, so lame. I watched Blue's Clues, and I remember watching Little Bill, and not very backyard games at the time. I really watched Playhouse Disney back then. Never in my life watch some Dora at all nowadays. It's so lame nowadays. You know, that's just me. And then at the time, yes, I got back into watching something else in mind, you know. And that is, of course, I'm talking about some PBS Kids, which is PBS Kids in the time, which is probably about Arthur, Barney, and things like that. But anyway, continue on.
I used to own a VHS tape of the show, which had a couple episodes from the first season. And I currently own this DVD, which still has a couple episodes but from later seasons of the show.
Hey, Gamer, where did you get that?
You mean the DVD?
Yeah.
I think I got it in a Best Buy back in 2005.
Wow, that's a long time.
Oh boy. Where's...
I wish I had a copy of this game.
Oh.
That's more like it.
Yep.
The game was developed by Global Star Software, part 2 Interactive, and was released in 2003. It was the only game made on the original PlayStation, and was one of the last titles for the system following its discontinuation 3 years later.
Watch is, Alex Paris just for you, buddy, on the whole... early versions of L4 GSTV before I got to find 2019. Continue on.
Once the game started, I get an FMV cutscene done in claymation. I know I said in my Toy Story review was set that the FMV cutscenes are condensed in the PS1, and there's nothing different in this game. It's still condensed, yes, but that's the technology it had back in the day. Anyway, let's just start the game.
Oh boy.
Finding Boots, we make our way to the farm and study the graphics in a PS1 game? Okay, I know you're trying to turn a 2D cartoon show into a 3D game, so basically there's nothing to worry about. Gameplay-wise, it's not that bad. You can move Dora with the analog stick, if you can enable analog mode, and pressing any button to do anything like jumping or telling Swiper to stop swiping. Oh, man!
Oh, boy.
Stars along the way. Anyway, Dora and Boots ask the cow why the gate is open. Well, according to the cow...
And now I can't find any of my farm animal friends.
Nothing I can say except please take better care of your animals because otherwise those run out.
Yeah.
There are 8 animal buddies to find. A duck, a pony, a goose, a sheep, a pig, a cat, a goat, and a chicken? Regardless, it's up to Dora and Boots to find their animal friends and return them to the farm. However, before they find the animals, they have to check the map and find out where each animal is at. And seeing that it's a kid's game, you have to call map.
Yeah, I'm not going to say map.
Not going to do it.
But Gamer, how are you going to know where the animals are if you don't know where the animals are?
Well, knowing the show, the map will still pop out even if you don't call map. It's not like it's voice activated or anything.
I won't let you continue until you say map.
Wow.
Well, that was quick. At least this game of the original show. Have Dora and Boots go to 3 locations, with the last location being the destination of where you need to go. And most of the locations are the ones in the show, like Crocodile Lake, Troll Bridge, the Little Blue Tree, Icy Cold River, Tall Mountain, and Blueberry Hill, where Swiper lives. Let's do some math here. You have 8 animal buddies to find and 3 locations per animal. That means there's a total of 24 different locations in the game.
Makes sense.
Not really much, but it's something I wanted to point out. Like I said before, you also look for stars that are scattered across each level, and some are even hidden in haystacks. By pressing the action button near a haystack, Bruce jumps in the haystack, resulting in finding not just a star, but even items needed to complete certain challenges.
Okay.
Overall, Barnyard Buddies is game, it does the job pretty well, teaching kids how to count both in English and in Spanish.
Yeah, which I'm not a fast batch. Sorry, T1.
You can take this straight from the show and replicate it in the game almost perfectly. Gameplay-wise, it's pretty good. It controls well, and it even has a bit of variety and challenges.
Uh-huh.
Is it a game I would play again? No, but at least it has some value to it.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a fan of the show looking for a good and basic educational game, then this is for you.
Yeah, no. Wow.
Next up, we have Journey to the Purple Planet, the GameCube.
Wow.
Before I talk about the game, I want to give a brief description about the episode the game was based on.
Wow.
Dora and Boots look through a telescope when they see a flying saucer crash into Earth, where five little aliens ask Dora and Boots to take them back home to the Purple Planet. They borrow Ethan Iguana's spaceship as they lift off from Earth and travel through the Milky Way into the space rocks in order to get to the Purple Planet and take the aliens back home.
Okay.
And that's it.
Wait a minute. I'm sure it was longer than that. I know. I was in there.
I know you did.
I know you are, yeah.
On to the game! The game starts off the same way as the episode does.
Uh-huh.
Boots looking through the telescope, the flying saucer crashing to Earth and coming down five little aliens.
What are your names?
Yeah, I don't speak Spanish, sorry. First of all, they're Inky, and these poor names are Inky, like, ew, nasty, then Owl? Seriously? Continue on.
Irritating Batman ghosts! They tell Dora and Boots that the Purple Planet is their home, and it's up to Dora and Boots to get these creatures back home. But before they do, they have to find Issa's spaceship. However, instead of running a few feet to get to the spaceship, like in the episode, they instead check the map as they traverse the locations that are, in fact, actual locations in the show.
Yeah. Wow.
The space gym is used for? Well, more on that later. But I will say that the spaceships can be found easily, whether they're scattered around the level or hidden in places like bushes, logs, and trees.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, you have to call on Boots to get the gym for you.
Okay.
Now that's out of the way. Let's talk about the main differences for the episode to the game.
Okay.
After getting to the tall mountain and lifting off Ethan's spaceship from Earth, the game decides to not use the same locations from the episode and instead have Dora and Boots fly the rocket to four different planets and get keys from each planet to unlock a space door and then go to the Purple Planet. Oh, and remember those space gems I mentioned earlier? It turns out that you need these space gems to fuel the rocket, but only five is needed to fuel the rocket, unlike in the show that has you replace a battery. Let me point out right now that once you get to the planet stages, this game can be boring.
Yeah.
Bland because each planet stage has a texture change and nothing else. Okay, there are some things that stand out for each planet. The green planet lets you slide around the place like you're skating with socks on. The yellow planet, or cheese planet, as I like to call it, lets you bounce everywhere you go.
Yeah.
The red planet has, well, it has water and ice, but that's it. And the red planet, don't you mean Mars? Has conveyor belts and radar beams. By the way, is it just me, or does computer Dora sound like the Cybermorph lady?
When did you learn to count?
As I said before, you have to find a key in each planet in order to unlock a space door to get to the Purple Planet.
Okay.
Before doing so, you have to check the map to find out where each key is located. And along the way, you collect space gems as well as certain items needed for certain tasks.
Okay.
At some point, you need to check your backpack to find a certain item needed to complete certain tasks. I love these sections because they perfectly match with the lore in the show. And seeing the blue cursor from the show is definitely a bonus. Anyway, after finding all the keys, you fly through the space rocks and make your way to the space door. Once all the keys are in place, you then warp your way to the Purple Planet after getting more gems for landing the rocket. Legend of the Purple Planet is a basic action-adventure game, but it feels like I'm playing through extended versions of the episode. Unlike the episode, with a length of 24 minutes, this game can take you up to 3 hours.
Wow.
The game does the job of making it educational. The puzzles are well thought and simple to solve, and it does teach kids about colors and how to count, like in Barnyard Buddies. But personally, this game is not for me. The levels look bland, the characters are given static emotions, and it's just not pretty to look at. I'm sure there are people that like this game or even grew up with this game, but again, it's just not for me.
But Gamer, didn't you say you had another game based on an episode?
I was just about to get to that. This brings me to the last game in the video, Dora Saves the Mermaids for PS2.
Wow.
Before I do,
you're not going to talk about the episode like you did before, right?
Let's talk about the episode.
Okay.
Makes
Dora
sense.
And Boosh pick up trash on the beach where they find a clan that tells them the story of the Mermaid Kingdom. But anyway, they help a mermaid named Mariana recover her magical crown and save the kingdom by wishing the Mermaid Kingdom to be clean again.
Oh, wow.
Evil octopus from dumping garbage all over the city.
Wow, that was quicker than the last one.
It is.
So
how was the episode on this DVD reflected into the game? Let's find out.
Hey, dude, did somebody say beach?
Yeah, he did.
Oh, hey, gamer.
Oh, hey, Alex, what's up?
Nothing much. Who's your friend?
Oh, I see. Boots, I'd like you to meet Hux, gamer, my little companion.
Hi, Hux. I'm Boots, Dora's companion.
Glad to meet you.
Anyway,
I was just curious. Later, dudes.
Wow, cat.
He sounds pretty cool.
He sure is. Anyway.
I want to point out that
unlike the last two games, which were developed by Global Star Interactive, Dora Saves the Mermaids was developed by Totally Games.
Wow. Wow.
The best known for the Star Wars X-Wing games, or pretty much anything that involves with intergalactical creatures.
Okay.
When we started the game, we see that the graphics are pretty much identical to Journey to the Purple Planet, satellite graphics and all. Seeing that I just talked about this game already, talking about them here would be redundant.
Okay.
Anyway, the game starts off in the same way as the episode. Dora and Boosh picking up the trash at the beach while they find a clan to tell them the story of the Mermaid Kingdom.
Cut.
As always, it's up to Dora and Boosh to find Mariana the Mermaid and recover hidden crown gems in order to get back the crown's magical power and therefore wishing the kingdom to become clean again and stopping the octopus polluting the ocean with garbage.
Cut.
Now, I have to give this game credit because this may be one of the only few games or minigames where the game's storyline is exactly the same as its source material. And I'm not kidding. This game follows the exact plot of the episode from start to finish, as if you're literally playing through the episode in video game form. It's actually amazing the more I think about it. Gameplay-wise, it's exactly the same as Journey to the Purple Planet, with its gem collecting whether scattered across the level or hidden in logs, trees, and bushes. But unlike Journey to the Purple Planet, the gems are used to unlock a chest at the end of every level that holds a gem for the magical crown. Even the backpack sections look exactly the same. But there are some differences, such as figuring out where to go next in the map, which I like for a kid's game. While the puzzles in Journey to the Purple Planet have some variance, the puzzles in this game have little to no variation at all. All the puzzles are just figuring out what color goes in what order. In fact, you can clearly see the correct order on the top left corner of your screen. What was it called? Oh yeah, cheating.
Wow.
But there are some other challenges, such as backing up the garbage left by the octopus and telling Swiper to swipe garbage? It never happened, and it probably never will.
You don't know that gamer. He might help us again someday.
No. I swipe backpack in map.
Oh, boy. Boy, it's just. Yeah.
You're right.
Other than that, it's pretty much it. There's little to no change when it comes to gameplay. But I will say that the one thing this game stands out from the others is the graphics. As I mentioned before, the main characters look exactly the same as Journey to the Purple Planet. But the graphics in this game, in my opinion, look much better because I enjoy having a beast aesthetic rather than a space aesthetic. And that alone will make this game boring for me. In addition, I feel like the levels were taken straight from the episode and replicated perfectly in the game, which once again makes you feel like you're playing the perfect video game tie-in of its source material. Because of this, I think this may be my favorite Dora game so far. My favorite level has to be the Mermaid Kingdom, which is the final level in the game. It looks gorgeous and beautiful, and it makes you want to explore the underwater world if I were able to. And seeing Dora transform into a mermaid is always a joy to my eyes.
Uh-huh.
So, gamer, how does the game end?
Oh, sorry, Boots. I got a little distracted there.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, after Dora saves the Mermaid Kingdom, the octopus catches Mariana with the net as Dora releases her from the net. As a result, the net catches the octopus, dropping him in a pile of garbage. The end.
Wow.
Wow.
Pretty cool. What did you think of the games, gamer?
Well, Boots, let me put it this way.
While the games do their job of educating kids pretty well, the graphics look pretty bland, and the gameplay feels a bit mediocre. I was going to say the games were short and precise for the kids, but the games can take you about an hour and a half for Barnyard Buddies and Dora Saves the Mermaids.
Uh-huh.
As I said before, Journey to the Purple Planet can take up to 3 hours to beat the game. As to which of these games I like the best, it would definitely be Dora Saves the Mermaids. Even though the game is an expanded version of the episode, I feel that this is the perfect example of how a video game tie-in should be, despite the graphics. So if you want to get hyped up for the Dora movie, then I would recommend watching the show. I don't think the games are something you want to play for hours on end, unless you're already a fan of the show. But I think you should still play it for the sake
of
you know, Boots, after playing these games, I feel as if I want to experience more Dora games. Someday, but not today.
That's okay. But if you do want to play more Dora games, you know who to call.
I will. Thanks, Boots.
Uh-huh.
You're welcome. And I couldn't have done it without you.
As I always do. I'm the Fairly Odd Gamer, and I wish you all good luck for the rest of your day or night, wherever you are. Take care, everyone.
So that was, hang on, one second.
First of all, I want to point out that as... Hey guys, Fairly Odd Gamer here. I want to point out that as of now, this channel has reached over 100 subscribers, and I cannot thank you guys enough for that. So to celebrate it, I'll be talking about Disney's most memorable duck.
Hold on,
I cannot thank you guys enough for that. So to celebrate it, I'll be talking about Disney's most memorable duck. That's right, next month will be Donald Duck Month. So on August 2nd, which is 2 weeks from now, the first video for Duck...
Hold on. Donald Duck Month, okay. There you go. You got a package. Oh, yeah. Shut the door, please. I can't hear a thing. Okay. Thank you. Anyway, continue on. I'm listening. So that was Fairly Odd Gamer episode number 10, Dora the Explorer Games. Well, congrats to, and he's now at 887 subscribers. And this game, this episode was mad to me at the time. The episode, yeah, because Dora the Explorer Games, the game 7s were just like, well, I'm not a huge fan of Dora the Explorer show. But the thing is, I used to be a fan of it, but I don't like it now. You know, that's just me, of course. But anyway, and that was the LJCB Ads episode number 860. Hope you enjoy it. Stay tuned. The next one's going to be LJCB Ads episode number 861. Playing of the Game Show, season 2 premiere. Till next time, through Jones and Bobby, so baby. I got to eat my lunch, so there you go with that. Good boy, LJPCBM, guys, be soon. Till then, out. See ya.
Given on to me, this life I'll never take for granted. And given all the time I failed to really understand it, I never sought to meet the maker of reality, the one who gave the life that which is always happening. But I tried all the time. I am. Why was I the one to see things as I do under the moonlight and the sun? Perception is the question, and the giver holds the key.